Welcome to Moving Forward. I'm Diane Williamson. This week's Student Spotlight has gone to the dogs. Very agile dogs, that is. Lydia Robbins is a freshman at New Albany High School, and in her free time, she participates in dog agility tournaments. What's dog agility?
It's where you have a set of obstacles, and you have to train the dog to complete them correctly, and you have to direct them where to go in a course. They're pre-sequenced. There's never a course that's the same. You can go out there and you can have a faster dog or you can have a slower dog. You know, all. It's nice because a variety of breeds and people can compete. There's contact obstacles, which are like the A-frame, which is like two boards that are in the shape of an A. And then there's a dog walk, which you'll see out there. It's kind of hard to explain. All the contact obstacles have like a yellow portion on them. You'll see, and the dog has to have a toenail in the yellow portion to qualify. And then the weave poles, you have to enter with the left shoulder. In the higher levels, there's 12 weave poles. And then the younger, like the novice, which is the easiest competition, you only have 6. I go to class on Mondays for an hour and a half with one dog, and then I trade them off week by week. But in the backyard, I come home from school and work like 15 minutes with each dog. Because they get tired, you know, they get mentally exhausted from the whole, you know, training. Because sometimes I'll go work in like a skill, or I'll go and work like a set of obstacles. So it depends. I started when I was about 9 years old. My Sheltie rookie needed obedience training, so we took the obedience training. And after the session was over, they said, you know, we're having an agility class, you know, if you'd like to sign up. And we're like, well, sure, you know. We've heard that Sheltie's always liked it, and we got started with him, and he loves it. So that's how it carried off.
I can hardly get my dog to come when I call him. So how does Lydia begin training her pets?
The first thing I do, I work with a lot of toy drive, which is like tugging, fetching, that kind of thing, because this breed usually doesn't engage with toys. Border Collies, Aussies, they really like to engage with toys. Sheltie's, you have to build it in them young. So I do a lot of I'll sit him down and I'll hold him back and I'll go, ready, set, go. And he'll go get the toy and then bring it back and I cheer and yell and, you know, we tug and we play and I just try to be as exciting as I can.
It looks like Lydia may have already found her calling in life.
I'm thinking about like opening my own training business because I help one of my instructors teach on Thursday nights. So maybe carry on my own kind of business.
Lydia recently competed at the AKC Nationals, where she was one of only 11 junior handlers, finishing well with a score of 274 out of 300 and earning a qualifying ribbon in the Time to Beat class. Our spring art shows are happening this month. The elementary art show at the New Albany Floyd County Public Library officially kicks off with a special reception next Tuesday evening, and the secondary art show at the Carnegie Center begins later this month. We'll provide more details about the shows and the contributing artists in next week's edition of Moving Forward. If you've got some great stories to tell about your school, please let me know about them. If you've got some great photos for our Facebook page, feel free to send them over. And make sure you stay up to date by checking out our website and following us on Twitter at NAFC Success. I'm Diane Williamson, and we'll see you next week on Moving Forward.